But I'll say this.
I feel left out.
It's pretty clear. As I was trying to figure out my sexuality in life, you know, that's, I'm just going to be honest. It's super gay. It's super gay. And by the way, it's hot. Like, I totally get it. Like,
what's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back at again with another video. So I wanted to show you guys this particular clip. I actually found this clip originally from someone I follow on Instagram. He's a wrestling fan. He goes by J Kinda Chill on Instagram. And he made some very interesting points about this particular clip I'm about to show you guys. But he didn't show the whole thing. He kind of talked about his points and his perspective on the conversation that was at hand. And basically, the conversation that these guys on a podcast were talking about is they didn't understand the hype for wrestling. Like, they didn't get why people got hyped up for wrestling and why it's, you know, there's a lot of people that are big fans of it. So I'm gonna play the entire clip. I was able to find it on TikTok. Let me pull it up for you guys real quick. Let me pull this bad boy up. So the as you see, the title, the search is "Pro Wrestling is Gay." Apparently one of the guys in this particular episode talks about, you know, how wrestling essentially is gay, and people are just, you know, they're kind of confused on the hype about it. It's crazy. That's what you have to type in to see this actual clip, but that's just, you know, that's kind of how they probably, you know, set it up for the algorithm. But we're going to play this clip and we're going to see what they have to say in their entirety, because I haven't seen the whole thing. I just kind of got gist of it, bits and pieces of it. So, and we'll see what they're talking about here. Let me.
Do you watch wrestling, dude?
No, not into it. Don't understand it. But I see the highlights, I'm like, that's scary.
If you can't understand wrestling, it's made for like anybody.
Yeah, but what I don't understand are why they just played at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia and had 100,000 plus.
Yeah,
it's
a massive event.
Why are 100,000 plus grown men cheering on these?
It's nuts.
Guys who are acting.
I know.
I don't. That's what I don't. I will never.
All right, let me break that down right there. Just off that alone. To say that it's confusing that 100,000 people are there to see someone act, in a sense, you could say the same thing about movies. People pay money to go see certain movies because of the action, the story, the characters. If with that logic, we should say, why are you paying so much money to go see this movie? Why are so many people going to see this movie or watch this particular show? Second of all, is there some acting involved in wrestling? Of course, there's a level to it. But at the end of the day, they are hitting each other. It may not be for every single punch. It may not be for every single situation. But they are hitting each other. I get what he's trying to go with the narrative. Well, you know, they're telling a story. And that is true. But there is actual wrestling going on within the match. And there is some physical combat going within the match. So to sit up there and be like, oh, trying to discredit it as, oh, it's just acting and that's it. I don't know about, I wouldn't go that far. But once again, I don't think he's well versed in it. So he doesn't even really know. He just sees it as, oh, it's all acting. How can anyone get into it? When it's actually more than just the sake of wrestlers just acting out a situation or a scenario. So that's just initially what I can tell from this clip so far. I wanted to address that.
Never they get understand. Into the it is their soap opera. I think that's the biggest way to look at it. It's like, this is their escape. This is their theater. They don't do Broadway. 100%. They don't do musicals, but they do a bunch of people from diverse cultural and physical backgrounds beating what looks like the shit out of each other.
100%. And I honestly.
And it ain't just what it looks like. They are beating the shit out of each other in some situations, not all the time, but a lot of times they are beating the shit out of each other. So I noticed that little what it seems like they're being. No, in a lot of these matches, you know, they are hurting each other. They're willingly hurting each other and also trying to protect each other at the same time. You can't fake getting hit with a suplex. You can't fake getting put in some of these submission holds. You know, they actually do hurt if applied correctly. You can't fake some of these chops to the chest, you know. And sometimes wrestlers end up being stiff. We've seen it, you know? So it's just one of those type of things where it's like, let's not sit up here and act like it's just all make-believe here.
Honestly, I spent a lot of time wishing that I could understand it and get into it.
Me too.
Because it feels like everybody I know gets it.
But I'll say this.
I feel left out.
It's pretty clear. As I was trying to figure out my sexuality in life, you know, that's, I'm just going to be honest. It's super gay. It's super gay. And by the way, it's hot. Like, I totally get it. Like, I get it, but it's super gay.
It is. I guess they're like wearing, they're sweaty, wearing spandex, like rolling around the ground with each other.
Brother, yeah, they're shirtless, they're muscular, like they're grappling with each other. Are you for real? Like the whole thing's sexual. The only thing that's not sexual is the bull squash storylines in between them grappling with one another. Like, what? This can't be breaking news to anybody. Two shirtless men in really tight pants wrestling one another? Like, what?
You've thought about this.
Yes, I think it helped a lot of people realize they were freaking gay. Comment if wrestling helped you with your sexual awakening.
Did it help you?
Yes.
Yeah?
Totally.
Interesting.
Which character was your favorite?
Oh, I don't... Yeah. Dude, I can't even go back to that time. That's too triggering, and I'm not opening up that deep box of worms, but I'm just making the statement that...
It was Hulk Hogan, wasn't it?
Ew.
That's so funny. I do wish I could get into it, though. I see the event you were talking about, Dan.
Yeah.
On the East Coast. What was it, a couple weeks ago?
Yeah.
Let me unpack that. So, wrestling is gay. And there's nothing wrong with being gay, but wrestling is gay, right? And it seems if he once was a fan, but now it's just like this taboo thing that represents gayness. If we're going by his logic, then anyone that watches UFC, they shouldn't be a fan of UFC. Or if they do watch UFC, they're gay. Because in UFC, there's a lot of grappling. There's a lot of wrestling involved. There's two guys, shirts off and shorts, you know, going in at each other. Pause. Like, if we're going by that logic, but... A lot of people love UFC. Same thing with boxing. Yeah, they got gloves on, the boxing trunks, no shirts. And a lot of times they're hugging on each other. I'm confused by that logic. So by his logic, what he just said, that would apply to UFC. That would apply to kickboxing, that would apply to boxing, any physical combat sport that involves you getting into close range with someone, most likely you're not going to have a shirt on, that would be considered gay. I don't know what happened to him that made him not want to be a fan anymore, but to generalize the whole fan base that something's gay because two guys are wrestling with each other, the actual professional sport of wrestling that's going to, you know, that's in the Olympics, like actual wrestling, I guess that would be gay too. I don't know, man. It's just, these takes is kind of wild. I'm not going to lie to you.
Last weekend, and it seems so fun, and everybody is there.
And they're just so into it, and the intros are so cool. And like,
yeah.
But, and they're cheering like they don't know what's coming, like. This was a script.
I know. And then there's like guest stars and people are losing their minds.
Yeah, they love it.
It's crazy. And I'm even like, I'm following the people on TikTok and Instagram who like work for the wrestling companies now, who aren't even wrestlers or anything like that. Like there's this, I think the ring announcer.
Yeah, but they're all characters.
Fascinating.
They're
I know.
All characters.
I think it's really cool. I wish I could get into it.
It seems like this guy right here that's actually kind of intrigued by it. He actually, it's like he's on the verge of wanting to give it a chance, but feels, you know, he's not wanting to still. Like he's fascinated by the fact that people are actually interested and actually enjoying the stuff and it seems cool, but it's like there's something that's holding him back. And it may be these other guys or people he's around is like, oh, that wrestling stuff is gay. But honestly, shit, he should give it a try. Go to a show and enjoy the experience. Like, I don't know.
You try again, you know, at this late stage in life.
I mean, I guess it does hurt, though, still. Like, when you're jumping off those...
Oh, it's hugely physical.
Those railings, what are they called? Not the ring?
Ropes?
They're jumping off the ropes, and they're jumping, like, 20 feet in the air and landing on someone.
Yeah,
that,
it's fine.
That can't feel great.
I'm sure it's it's legally a bouncy house. It's fine. Do you watch wrestling, dude?
No, not.
Yeah. This was very interesting, man. Not even gonna lie to you. This one was. It's. I'm not gonna sit up here and give them a whole bunch of hate and criticism because that's not my point here. But it is. It's kind of a wild take to have, considering some of the points that they made. It's like, well, one, that's not the case. And if you're gonna go with your logic, then you shouldn't like a lot of, if any, physical combat of sports. You shouldn't, if it's quote unquote gay. And you can't get it, and you can't understand it, which is fine. Not everyone's meant to. But at the same time, to discredit it as if it's just some soap opera, which to an extent it is a soap opera, a manly-ish, soap opera-ish type style, because there's storylines that you get invested in, characters that you care about, but at the same time, there's still the physical aspect, and there's still some wrestling involved in it. Someone would say, oh, but you know who's going to win. Even if you do know who's going to win, you're there for the story. The same thing with movies. You knew when you were watching the Avengers saga. You knew when you were watching Infinity War, you know, and they set it up for part one, part two, and you saw that Thanos had won in part one. You knew in part two that, you know, ultimately the Avengers would succeed. You just didn't know how. But guess what? Everyone went to the theaters to see how it played out, even though you knew how it was going to end. You knew the Avengers were going to win, but you didn't know how. It's the same thing here. It's more or less the same thing, except with more of the physical aspect. Sometimes you do know what's going to happen. It still makes the ride that enjoyable. Sometimes you don't know, and it makes it even unpredictable. So that notion, oh, you guys know who's going to win and lose. Sometimes you do, based off the story. Sometimes you don't. But that's what you're there for, to see how things play out. I hate when people try to discredit wrestling, but at the same time confused on why it's so big and how it's gotten bigger. Simple. People love entertainment. People love stories. And if you can combine the two with the physical side of it, you have something special. I'll break it down even further. You want to know why people like some UFC fights, or you want some boxing fights, legendary ones? Because of the story. They're there to sell tickets. So there may be some real beef with two boxers or two UFC fighters, and they do the background situation and figure out their information and why they don't like each other. The story. People want that added level of intensity to the story. And that's the same thing here with wrestling. I'm not going to sit up here and discredit something that's bringing in hundreds of thousands of people and selling out venues and making millions upon billions of dollars and getting $5 billion Netflix deals. Obviously, it's there for a reason. Obviously, it's gotten much bigger for a reason, because people enjoy the storytelling. People enjoy the characters. People enjoy the talent that goes into the ring. Because best believe, there have been situations where people have went off script and did shit on their own and legitimately was out there beating the crap out of each other. Hell, New Japan Pro, that's what they're known for being very stiff and very physical. Same thing. And whether it's predetermined or not, that's fine. But that's why it's called sports entertainment. They're combining both worlds. I just wouldn't discredit it. You know, so this is a very interesting topic, and I want to get y'all opinion on it. Because me personally, I just feel like that, you know, that take and the take that they've had, these individuals on this podcast, a lot of people have that take. They look at you kind of funny. Granted, it's not as much as it used to be. I think wrestling is becoming even more mainstream back again. You know, like in the 90s, it was super mainstream. It kind of died off. Now it's starting to get that rise back again. I think, you know, there are still some people out there that will criticize you or look at you funny because you're a fan of wrestling. And honestly, you know, I don't even think they truly realize that they're potentially missing out on something great. And it seemed like somebody in this particular podcast, the guy, I think he had the black shirt on with the glasses, He seemed like he was, you know, curious about it, but wasn't too sure. So, but comment down below. Let me know your thoughts and opinions on their particular take about wrestling. Because me personally, I think it's kind of wild. You know, I'm not going to give them hate for it. I just think they're, you know, misinformed. They don't really truly understand. And by their logic, they shouldn't like a lot of combative sports by their logic. So let me know how y'all feel about this whole particular situation. But I appreciate all the love and support. Road to 150K, and I'm still young, speedy YouTube wrestling champion of the world. Appreciate y'all kicking with me. See y'all next one. Peace.